Hey guys, here we are back on Wind Chaser doing more tillage. Pretty much did a full day of tillage already, and we're not even. Well, we're getting pretty close to being done. We're like halfway done with a few fields. We still have 26 to do, and currently working on 25 here. So we had probably at least another full day of tillage, depending on. Other people log on and help me out, but I did a lot last night. Logged like 3 hours of playing on this last night, so it's been like 6 months since last time I put in that much time playing. So I knocked out field 13, 14, and then like half of what you can see here. So. Well, half of 13, actually, and all of 14, and then, like, a few passes here. That was, and then I'm, of course, I mowed and merged and built, so. That's pretty much all you can do in 3 hours, so. You don't get much done on this map. So, it's very time-consuming to farm as much land as we are, and, you know, we're not even farming that much land. In regards to how much is available to farm on the map, so. If I had to guess, I would guess the amount of acres that is farmable is probably around 22 to 2,500 acres, perhaps. In my old save game, I was doing a little bit less than this, and it was around 800 acres. Actually, I was doing like 4 fields less on my crops every year. It was like 800 acres it came out to, so. So I imagine it's probably close to 2,500 farmable acres on this map. In all, you know, if you were to farm all the available land, which is a pretty decent chunk of land, it would take you. You know, a pretty decent amount of time to actually farm it if you were doing it yourself. My growth with the soil mod, the interval times, is 5 days. So I have 5 days to get everything finished before it updates to the next growth stage. So that means all of my liquid NPK would evaporate and all of the crops would go on to next growth stage. So we have 5 days to get everything done. You can obviously stagger some of your fields. You could put it on like a stage ahead or stage behind. So you can do, you know, you have like 10 days you could do all of your primary tillage, or you can do it, you know, if you have enough land, you can break it up into, you know, have 3 different growth stages. But I mean, in reality, that's not, everything is, you have a harvest window, but for the game purposes, if you're a week behind on like half of your fields, and then you stagger half and half about a week apart, it's easier for tillage, and it's easier for harvesting and stuff like that. Right now, we're obviously able to get it all done within our primary tillage. We went through 1 full day. This is our 2nd day. We're winding down. It's like 1,600 hours, 1,700 hours. So we'll be able to do our primary tillage on all of our fields in 2 days. Well, not all of our fields, all of our newly acquired fields, most of them have chopped straw, have some grass, and then we obviously sprayed NPK. So our other fields that we've been farming for a season now, they're already like really good with the nutrients, so we just sprayed NPK. So we'll probably just run over with some kind of a field cultivator, some kind of light vertical tillage. There's no reason at this point to drag our chisel plows into fields we've already put a lot of work into last season. One thing that I'm probably going to do is I'm going to probably rent the DN and broadcast some limestone before we actually cultivate, because a lot of our fields are around 6.2, 6.1, you know, like 6.0 on the pH. So we're going to have to broadcast some limestone and cultivate that in too to get a nice boost in our pH. Get back to a little bit more basic and neutral in anticipation of spraying more nutrients and more herbicides. So overall, I think we're doing really well, and the soil, the moisture content in these fields, it's not terrible, but it definitely requires a lot of work, a lot of good rains. These fields will probably end up maybe around 40 to 50% moisture, which isn't the greatest, but it's pretty difficult to maintain and increase your soil moisture unless you have some good rain. So, and you can't like cheat and like trigger a rain when you're on a dedicated server like you can in a single player when you yourself are hosting a multiplayer game. So anyways, I absolutely love how this map looks in the mornings and evenings with the lighting, and it just really makes everything pop, and the trees, and really just makes everything look good, including even the dusty textures. But yep, that field right there, that's a soybeans, old soybeans, you know, basically the nutrients in that field is tall crap, so that's our last newly acquired field that we have to chisel plow. 14 is actually going to be a fairly fun field to harvest on, this one as well. This one will be another really good field that we picked up. I'm definitely going to be purchasing this field, field 25, once we get the funds to do it. I've never farmed it before, in, you know, like the year and a half that actually I did it once before, but it was completely different layout. But it's a little flat for me. I want to make it a little bit more subtle, gradual hills in here, especially there by the road. It's kind of like a low point, but I definitely want to increase the height of the terrain because it looks kind of just goofy, and it's just sloping down to like a bowl. You know, it's almost like a bowl, so I want it to be a little bit flatter, if not make it a little bit hillier in that low point, so it's not so bowl-like. And, you know, it makes it a little bit more interesting to drive and do your field work with. So I was contemplating plowing up this grass and expanding the field. We probably will, but that's not even sprayed yet, so it really doesn't make. You can see our line where Mike finished spraying, so I actually plowed it a little bit outside of where he sprayed, but definitely want to expand into this little area here, you know, just to finish off this field. But that'll probably be the following season. So we are El Dono with our first pass, then we're just going to work our way back here. Work. I guess there's a little bit I'm gonna have to catch it up here, but added this river. It's kind of you know, I didn't really know what to put over here, so I have a little back woodsy trail in the mountains here going up to the radio tower, and I just made a continuation of a river because I had a lake and there was nothing, there's no contributaries, you know, kind of like flowing into that. So I made kind of a small little river, nothing too major, but definitely spruced up this area that kind of needed a little bit more detail, and added a new really detailed grain complex over here with train tracks and such like that. Field 34 up here, we don't own it or lease it yet, but that would be the last field down here on this side of the map that we need to pick up. It's kind of an awkward looking field. It's definitely one of the fields where a farmer's like, I don't want to farm it, but I need the acres. We don't really need the acres right now. We don't really want to farm it, so that's why we kind of just put it off. We'll probably pick it up in another season or two. But right now we're pretty much set with the amount of acres we're farming, I mean, we essentially more than doubled the acres we were farming from the previous season, so. Finally, I know I mentioned in the last video, but I just messed around with the alfalfa a little bit, so it would regrow, and messing around with the textures, because there was, it was set up with like 9 states, 8 grow stages, you know, like a regular crop, where grass only has 4 grow stages and cut states, so I had to like go back and look at all the DDS files, because So it looked good when it was growing at the first growth stage when you first planted it, and then, you know, stuff like that. So it seems to look really good now. When I first started making changes, it was like really weird, but it's all worked out, and I'm pretty happy with it. It avoids withering, and it just regrows. So cleared up a lot of confusion of like the additional the multi fruit when you're doing additional fruit types, how to add that in. When it gets knocked back, what kind of cut state it gets knocked back to when you harvest it. So I'm pretty happy with the result now. Because I was at a point where I'm like, well, alfalfa yields, you know, like a point higher than grass does per square meter. So it's definitely makes sense to plant alfalfa, but it took longer to grow, and it didn't regrow, and before I had soil mod in, I was using the LUA files for like the individual fruits, like the 13 method, and it worked really great then, and then for whatever reason, soil mod just kind of, it wasn't soil mod, it was just my lack of understanding of how, you know, the whole number of states and grow states and stuff like that. I didn't have a firm understanding of that, or really understood, you know, the explanation or definition of what each meant. So now I do, and it works great, and I'm happy. So I'm probably gonna, I'm thinking of adding some new fruits. I'm thinking of adding like a sorghum. I'm thinking of adding like a clover, maybe some sunflower. Just add more fruits to this map, because right now it's just alfalfa, oat, and soybean, you know, the same three that I've been using since I started playing this game 2 years ago, so. And I definitely want to start looking into, like, a peanut crop and, like, start making peanut harvesting equipment, and I think if we set it up like a wheat and a barley with a windrow, that you can have like the mergers just pick up, the defoliate pick up, and kind of like pile the windrow, and then you can build a second lifter that would harvest and then like pick up the windrow too. So I think that would be something like. I know in 13 I had a swather and then the pickup header, and I think they have the same thing in 13 now. I haven't really paid much attention, but that's definitely the same kind of technique and how I would strip the crop in 15. But I definitely think like peanuts are like a new way of potato harvesting. Would be a good way to do it, because I know like the self-propelled harvesters, they defoliate and harvest too, so if like you can just like defoliate, harvest, and then like pile the windrow. But right now potatoes and they don't have the ability to windrow, but I think it wouldn't be that difficult to add a windrow for potatoes, you know, kind of like how they do it in you know, out west, or like the Idahos and stuff like that. They have kind of like merge 2 sides, 4 rows, you know, 4 rows on the left, 4 rows on the right. They merge it into the middle 4 rows, and then you have a big lifter that picks up 4 rows plus those other 8 merge. So it's like you're picking up 12 rows of potatoes. I don't know, it's extremely efficient and it looks cool, and I think it would be fun to incorporate. And to my knowledge, it's never been done. And there's no like Sputnik equipment. You know, even those Spugnik lifters, they look really cool. They don't look very difficult to make. You know, it's just a lot of open framing and some belts. And, you know, not that it would be easy, but I think it wouldn't be very difficult to visualize everything and build it accurately. So. Run some like 8RTs, you know, single track machines, or like a 765 series to pull the lifters, or you know, run some narrow row crops. Because grain farming is okay. I mean, corn's great. I love the capacity of corn. But I mean, when you look at 28 to 30 ton an acre beets or whatever potatoes are, I'm assuming potatoes are roughly the same tonnage per acre. That keeps everyone really busy on their toes. You got dump carts, you got trucks. But this map obviously is not set up to handle that kind of farming. I would definitely have to do a lot of work to get the map up to something like that. I mean, it would definitely require a lot of work to get, you know, you have to build all the machines, you have to script all the machines, you have to test your scripting of the machines, you have to make new fruits, you have to get the fruit images, you have to just, you know, test. You know, it requires a lot of work, but I think the amount of fun you can have harvesting would make it worth it, because it's so different, so unique, so, you know, something fresh and new. And whatever. I have a lot of things I want to do. Like, I have so many ideas, but I don't have any time anymore. So, I mean, like, when I do have time, I have no energy. I have an evening off where I don't have to do study or don't have to do patient records or stuff like that, or if I don't have to do my lab work, you know, my time is spent doing other things than modding now. I can't remember, it's been like at least a month since I opened up Blender, so it's been a long time. I have so many projects I started. I started building a 2730. I started building a land roller. I started building a foldable 3-section beet lifter. I started building a Rogator. I started building a 765 series Challenger. You know, all these projects are started on my 60-foot Tiger Mate. But it requires so much, you know, we're looking at probably like at least 300 hours of work to get all these projects finished. So it's, you know, I don't see that happening anytime soon. So. Anyways, I absolutely love this plowed terrain. The color of it just compared to, you know, the grass and you know, at the same time I wanted to make a new 4X map based on the area where I'm from, but you know, I know nothing about using DEM, so I have to teach myself and learn how to use that to build the map off of real terrain topography. So but that will happen. I can guarantee that will happen. Whether it's a year or two or three from now, I don't know, but it's definitely going to happen sometime. Just not anytime soon. This field is really big. I'm wondering what we should plant in here. If we were to plant corn, this would be outrageous yield. But definitely. I think we're going to do 27, 28 to Porn, 26, 25 to, like a barley canola, soybean, something like that. Do 14 to Corn, 13 to Corn. I like to get a little bit more corn this year because what we got here. Corn. So we pretty much need 1.5 million more liters, which is probably like 3 big fields. Canola, that's really low. Soybean, I'd like to get about 1 million more liters. Definitely want to get, you know, a decent amount of barley. I want to get, let's say, a grape demand. We're looking at 54,000 liters a truck. You know, 108,000 per trip. So we could probably buzz down Budweiser and back in 10 minutes. We're looking at, you're probably looking at 6 truckloads you can get in to Budweiser. So probably really want to get around probably 650,000 liters of barley, and that yields about the same as soybeans. So we'd have to plant, I think if we planted 2 big and 1 small, we would get, we'd be right there. And then corn. So yeah, we're definitely gonna have to figure out what kind of you look in the map, we'd be pulling right there by the north part of, we'd be pulling our grain in from our grain facility right there at the main farm at north of 3, north of 3. So we have to drive all the way into town, go in, drop off at Budweiser, come back, load. So I'm thinking it's probably going to be a 10-minute round trip, probably more like 8. But on the safe side, 10. So that's 10 truckloads. We always get some great demands at Conagra. We can go there and back in like under 5 minutes. Everything else, I think, is pretty well. You know, co-op doesn't really have that many great demands as compared to the others. So, but we're definitely going to be planting barley just to capitalize on the Budweiser great demands. Everything else, you know, there's some pigs, some beef, great demands. There's a lot of sand at Semstone. And my thought is if we do, we could do 44, We'll figure it out. Anyways, I'll probably end the video here, so thanks for watching.